This one here, I got the thermostats turned on. It's like 64 degrees in the house. I set it on 70, waiting for it to come on. I have not checked anything. The first thing I'm gonna do is open up the panel. Be sure we got voltage. If it don't have voltage, pretty much you're not gonna get anything else. Hopefully this is something simple so I can get back home. It's nice and cold out here. 41, 42 degrees. So let's find out what will be revealed the problem is.
Okay.
Okay, we need a quarter. Let's try the right size. Thermostat's been on for about 3 minutes. So it might be a 5 minute delay. I didn't look at the thermostat and see. If there's a delay on that digital one or not. But we're gonna see if we got power or whatever out here. See what's going on. See the capacitor is swollen or anything. Don't see anything like burnt mark wires or anything. Voltage, we have the high voltage. And we have low voltage because there's an LED light on. Let's see. Where's my common? Red, we have 24 volts. All right. On the yellow wire, we have 26 volts. Thermostat is sending power out to here. Nothing on the O terminal. On the W1, we have power. So we are getting power sent out here. So let's see if it's the contact. See if we got any power on it. We have no power at all on the contactor. Let's see if we have a low pressure switch in here. That's something you don't find instructions or whatever that is about it. Usually they are thrown away. Let's see here. Defrost. Low pressure. Let's see here. Low pressure switch. Defrost switch. High pressure switch. Let's see if we get any pressure. Okay, we got gas in there, so most likely it's probably got enough. I'm thinking probably the defrost board, because I do see some corrosion on some of the terminals on the board. So there's a good possibility that it will be defrost board. So let's check, see. All right. fire ties out of the way. And I have turned off the high voltage just in case it wants to kick on. Just in case it does kick on, only thing that's going to happen is the contactor pulled in. That's it. I don't recall exactly what the codes are for the LED lights on here. So I'm going to look up in the book and see, unless it actually has it written on the inside of the panel. Would be nice if it was. But, aha, there we are. Okay, let's see what it says. See, LED. It says high pressure lockout. It says high pressure lockout is what it says the problem is. High pressure. Can it be that, but he's had it off, so why is it still high pressure? Or does it need to be reset? Now, is this R22 or 410A? I'm taking it, yep, it's a 410A. I got the sticker right here. It's not a hot pink sticker, but it's got 410A written right on it. So, it's high pressure. Now, why would high pressure kick in? It can be simple as the indoor fan is not running and the indoor coil is building up pressure and building up, then it kick in. Or, see if it's got one. Probably does. TXV can be not opening like it should be and it will build up pressure. So I guess the next thing we need to do is if we could reset the board and check the pressure on the system and see if it says it's high pressure, or is it that the high pressure switch is malfunctioning and shutting the system down prematurely. So let's find that out. All right, we have a standing pressure on the high and low of 120, 121. It's fluctuating. So let's see if we can reset and run the unit and see if the pressures actually go up or not, to find out if the pressure switch is just malfunctioning and actually opening up when it does not supposed to. So let's try that and see what happens. By taking the R terminal, whatever wire is on there, taking it off and putting it back on, will reset the defrost port itself. And now it's altering between the two, and I do believe that is going to be the 5-minute delay. So when you take the wire R terminal off, it will reset that board. Now it's alternating. Let's see where that's at. Alternating slow flash is a 5-minute anti-short cycle delay. And that's what it's doing. And usually I give the model and serial number, but I don't actually, here we are. I would go give it to you here, but this is kind of destroyed a little bit. But the only other place I see is right here. So we're gonna see if the contactor will pull in after the 5 minute delay. And then we're gonna check the pressure, which I have it in heat mode, so I have the low side tap on the direct tap here. And on the big line for the high side, which becomes the high side in heat mode. So now we're just waiting for the 5 minute delay. 5 minutes is not that long, but when you're waiting for every second of it, seems forever, ever, 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 ever. So now we're just waiting for it to click, and then we will put the power to it and see what the pressures will do. As you see, the lights are still alternating, so it should be very shortly that the timer should be running out of 5 minutes. So we're just waiting for it to be 5 minutes. There's the 5 minutes. Now we're going to put the disconnect, the service disconnect, back in, check the pressures, and see if it escalates enough where the high pressure should shut the system down. So let's see. She's out of the way. Now what she's going to do, she might go right straight up. it's really not jumping up real fast. Usually if it usually if it's a TXV or restriction in the line, usually it goes right up. It don't have to wait for it to really build up that long, but she's not escalating too fast. Let's run and see what happens. Well, I'm sitting here looking at the chart, and according to it, with it being about 40, between 40 and 45 degrees outside in the heat operation, the pressures should be around 310 and 96. 310 and 96. Let's see what we actually have. We're supposed to have roughly about 310 and 96. And that is going by 40 degrees outside. It might be colder than that. Let me check and see what the actual temperature here is actually at. At my house, it was 43 when I left. I have no idea what it is here. It might be cooler. Let me check and see. And then that would tell me if the numbers are where it's supposed to be. Well, I checked on the temperature. The outdoor temperature is reading like 38 and a half. So that will make it drop a little bit lower than 310, that's what it's calling for. And we are reading right now 91 and a half and 310. And it's not rising. And it's been running for 6 or 8 minutes. So we just have to let it run and see if the high side goes up or not. Now I got my bag off of it, so it can breathe. And it's still running 92 and 313. And it's jumping between 310 and 313. Okay, now since I took my temperature outside, after it's been sitting for a little bit, it was actually reading the wrong temperature, because after it's been sitting here, it's risen some. So the actual number that it finally topped out at is 45.7. Hopefully you can see that. 45.7 is the temperature. 45.9, and this is the setup I have to check the outside. So it's almost, 46 degrees. So that's going to make it actually, pressure is actually a little higher. So 45.9. So 45.9, so 46. That's going to be very close to the next mark is 50. And it should be 328 on the high side. 328. So 328 is what it should be running, it says. And that's ballpark, a little bit, probably a little less than that, because that's a 50 mark, and it's actually 4 degrees roughly lower. And we are running between the two temperatures, 40 and 50, outside ambient temperature. One's supposed to be 310, the other one's supposed to be 318, I do believe, was it not? At 40, supposed to be 310, 50, supposed to be 328. And it's somewhere between that. And we are running 320. We're running 320. So that sounds about right, because it's just a short of 50. And it's supposed to be 3. It's just a short of being 50 degrees out here. And if it was 50, it should be reading 328. But it's only reading like 46. So it should be a little less than 328. And we're reading 321. So the numbers are reading okay, according by the chart. No idea why it kicked out. Let's go inside and check the temperature that we have coming out of the vents and see what we got there. Alright, it has been running for at least 20 minutes. And you saw what the vent temperature was and what the return temperature was. Now, of course, the heat strips are on because the thermostat is set more than, you know, than 2 degrees above, or whatever the differential is, 1, 2, or 3, whatever it is, the heat strips are on as well. And we are still running 95, 322. So it's holding. Why did the high pressure kick out? Don't know. Perhaps it got trash in there and made it clog up, and by me putting it in, making it go in air condition for a few seconds, it might have got it out. I don't know. But they had it off when I got here. Now we're sitting at 322. High enough to kick out the high pressure switch, at least not now. Why? Don't know. It runs fine in air condition with the pressures, you know, not escalating or anything. I got a heat mode. It's not going up. But right now, according to the chart, with the temperature outside and everything, the pressure is right where it's supposed to be. Something got a line somewhere, and it was a temporary mishaps. Or I've seen it where a power surge will make a defrost board say something that actually didn't happen. Or the defrost board is malfunctioning itself and needs to be replaced, but right now it's not telling me that. And we are still running 320, 321, 322, 323, 322, 321, 320, 319, 18. So it's fluctuating. So leave in the comment what you think it might be, or what it could have been that caused the high pressure kick out when it's not showing that it should have.